the two-ply veneer. This has birch on one side and mahogany on the other. And you can see the grain on this side runs this way, and the grain on this side runs this way. And this side is slab cut. Slab cut means it was cut from a slab, which means they cut the veneer and then join the edges together. This side is called roller cut, which they just slice it off and roll it like that. So I'm cutting this up because I'm gonna make some business cards out of this.
The entire 8-foot by 4-foot sheet was cut into uniform pieces that would fit into the laser machine. I had to put these plywood boards on the veneer sheets to keep them flat until I could use them. Each side was sanded to 220 grit to make them smooth. In order to hold the veneer sheets down onto the laser bed, I made a hold-down apparatus with some nails and strips of thin plywood. Underneath, I put clamps on the ends of the nails to provide weight.
That's pretty clever, huh?
A sheet of veneer was placed on the laser bed and marked at the top center. Then I positioned it under the hold downs. I adjusted the laser tip to mark the very top center of the veneer piece. The laser was set at a very low wattage so that it would only leave a faint mark in the wood. On my computer screen, I created registration marks on the four corners of my image, just outside the border, and inscribed it lightly onto my veneer piece to make sure it was in the optimal position. When I was satisfied, I increased the wattage so the registration marks would cut all the way through the veneer. That would essentially produce the same marks on the other side of the sheet. Now I was ready to send the image to the laser machine. I set the wattage to make the laser burn at the perfect depth, which I figured would be nearly through the first layer of veneer. Then I let the machine do the work. Notice that I had to put a weight, in this case a thin steel file, on the center so that it would not bulge. Then I had to manually move it as the laser head progressed. The first side was finished. The veneer sheet was turned over and positioned back into the holder. I placed a weight on it and then tried to move the sheet to dead center. I did not want to move the laser head though, because I wanted to keep the same setting as the other side. Then I lowered the wattage and proceeded to adjust the sheet so that it would inscribe exactly where the registration marks were cut through from the other side. As I had expected, this would take several attempts. When I was satisfied, I turned up the wattage and sent it one more time to make sure. You can see that the marks were almost exactly in line with each other. Now it was time to import the image, center it onto my template, adjust the wattage to the optimal depth, and then send it to the machine. Each side takes more than 3 hours to engrave. When it was complete, I decided to test the QR codes. They worked perfectly. Now I could send my cutting template to the machine. This is a different type of function. The laser cuts in line instead of making several passes. It doesn't really go this fast. The film was sped up. It actually cuts this fast. When the cycle was complete, I removed the individual cards. The laser machine was finished with its work. Not all the work was complete. Residue from the burning laser beam had made marks on the bottom side. Each card had to be individually sanded. After that, each card was cleaned with compressed air and individually inspected. Only then could they be packaged and sent to my customer.